Welcome back to our channel where we have been teaching you how to grow your own food using a simple deep water culture system, which is part of a hydroponic system. And we have various videos that we've already put out. If you have not seen them, I'll put them in the cards or in the description box below. And in this video, if you have not set up your system yet, Dr. Riz will show you how to set up the Savvy Grow Kit and all the items that are included in the kit. And he will also show you how to set up your LED lights.
Welcome back to another episode of Hydroponics for Beginners by a Beginner. I'm Dr. Riz. Today, we're going to make a short video to show you how we prepare our deep water culture system for indoor hydroponics. Here, I am using a kit that was made by Savvy Grow, which is a company that I encountered on Amazon, and we have a link in the description. So this is not an ad for them. You can use anybody that you'd like. Right now, I'm putting together the water level indicator. The tub is already pre-cut with the appropriate holes, and then you put rubber grommets through the holes. It also comes with a clear tubing, which you need to cut to size. It's actually a little longer than you need. So every kit I have purchased, it was a little bit longer, so you kind of carefully have to fit it to size. And you put it into the fittings that come with it. And then once you get your clear tubing cut to size, you put it into the fittings, and then the fittings are pushed through the rubber grommets into the tub. And then you have your water level indicator. Next, you'll see me preparing the aerator system. In the kits that I have purchased, it comes either with black tubing or clear tubing, and some of the kits come with a one-way valve to prevent the backflow of water into the air machine. This particular kit has that. Other kits have not, so you'll have to individualize it. Here I'm going to cut the tubing so that I can insert the one-way valve. And so I put the one-way valve as suggested per their instructions, and I cut about 3 to 4 inches away from the end. And then now you'll see me blowing on the valve to find which way the airflow actually works. And then I plug it into the tubing. I plug that tubing into the air machine. And so now you have to think about making sure you plug it the correct way so that the air is flowing only one way from the machine into the tub. So here I'm putting the tubing through the already pre-cut hole, and I'm connecting the air stone. In this particular case, it's a round air stone. And now you kind of have your setup. Here's the top that I've put on, and then the net cups that come with it. At this point, you can see me putting the rock wool in. When you're doing this for real, the rock wool will have your seedlings in it. So you'll place your rock wool into the net cups. Next, you'll use the pebbles that come with the kit to cover the rock wool and prevent some light. It also helps prevent algae from forming on the rock wool. So there you have it. That's kind of the basic setup. I do fill the water to the point where it gets just below the net cups. The aeration system allows for the rock wool to get moist. Here I'm just quickly showing you another setup, and it's a similar kit, but you can kind of see that the components are a little bit different. The tubing is clear. And here it's a different rock stone. Rather than a round ball rock stone, this is a triangular long piece, and they both do the job. So my initial setup that I did a few months ago when I was a beginner was two tubs just like this. And then I also purchased a lighting system for it, and these lights are specifically made for growing plants. And here I'm showing the one I purchased, and the link is in the description. It is a fairly easy system to set up. It comes with two lights. Depending on the height above your plants that you mount the lights, it will change the area of coverage and the intensity of the lighting. Here I'm putting the base together, and it's a pretty sturdy base. It actually takes up a little bit of space, so you have to be able to find space for it. And then I've also found some creative ways to hang these lights without using the mounting system. And it comes with three vertical connectors, and you don't have to use all three. It just depends on what height you want these lights to be at. I have used them at the first and second level, and then also the third level, depending on how close I wanted my lights to be to the plants. There is a swivel with a double connector that is made, and you can connect it directly to the vertical pieces. Everything twists together. You don't really need any tools. It actually comes with a small wrench that helps you tighten the bolts that come with it. And then the last thing is that there's the cords that supply the electricity for the lights, and you can see them here in this picture. I actually have tidied them up, and I use twist ties to attach them to the bars in order to make it all nice and clean. All told, this system will need 4 electrical outlets. I have the aerators connected to electricity all the time because I'm aerating the plants 24 hours a day. Incidentally, the aerator machines come with a little knob that will turn up or turn down the intensity of bubbles. And then I have the lights on a separate plug connected to a timer, and then I can choose how much light I want to provide on a daily basis. I have varied it anywhere from 12 hours to 17 hours of light, depending on my goals. And that's it. That's that's the basic setup for the deep water culture hydroponic system that I have utilized as a beginner. Over time, I have modified things used different ways of hanging the lights, I'm sure you will too as you gain more experience.
If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe, because next time Dr. Riz and I will show you how to grow your own microgreens. And this is part of a challenge. He will grow in water and I will grow in soil. Who will produce the best microgreens? Make sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching.
Don't forget to subscribe. Subscribe.
Hit that notification button.